So this is the second lesson with starting the texturing procedure. We'll be going over many things about fitting as much texture usage in a square as we possibly can without wasting any space. And a couple other things, so let's get started. Okay, so what I'm going to show you here is how to get our textures. Here's just a little reference of our what we're going to be using for our base textures, just temporarily before we make the color and diffuse textures. So basically what we're going to be doing here is taking this pillar here, this metal window pillar, and I'm going to create a new document, 40 by 96 by 40 by 96. And make it a resolution of 72. What we're going to do here is basically we're going to crop this, but make sure when you're cropping you have perspective on, because this will crop a picture that's shot on a little bit of an angle into a straight flat picture. So what I'm doing is I'm taking the corner. If you're not in a perspective, you can't grab just the corner. You can't manipulate all four corners. So taking the corner and placing it on this edge between the top line and the vertical line. And then I'm going to take the other corner and place it in the same place, going by the top line. And then I'm going to take this, and you basically just want to line it up to the perspective of the image. So all these corner lines are going to be lines, but that's not going to work because it's not going directly to that plane or perpendicular to that. So we're going to move it up to here and make sure that it's lining up with our top lines as well as the bottom ones. And a little trick I learned a while ago, if you match it up to something else, like this blue window here, that we know is exactly the same perspective. It's a fairly easy concept, but if you have like one corner wrong, it's gonna mess up the whole thing. So you really gotta make sure, bring out the edges, and then just hit the check mark for that. Actually, we need this granite too, so. Okay, let's test it with the marquee tool and see if it's a straight line. It's not bad, but it's a little bit off. We'll just be using this as a guide. It's not the final reference. But what I'm going to do to just kind of solve it is just rotate the image and then bring a guide down to see if it's level. So it looks like that's level. So I'm just going to hit enter. And after I lay this guide down, kind of just check. It's a pretty straight line. So I hit the check mark. And then we're just going to crop it from the rest of the unneeded spot. So, just gonna turn off my snap and then just bring this over to the inside a little bit more. Just so we don't get that white background. Then we're just gonna place this in our texture sheet as our first object, and we're gonna snap it to the bottom right corner. So now we're gonna crop the door out and this top molding part where this marble is. And we're going to put it in perspective, and then we're going to move the corners around to make sure that we get this image that's kind of on an angle into a flat head-on shot. Make sure it's level, and then just extend the edges out to what we need. And then just hit enter, or the check mark. And that looks pretty good. You know, just bring a guide down here and just check it. That's, you know, that's pretty level. So what we're going to do is copy it over and bring this into our texture sheet. And then we'll just place it up there and then place it right next to here. And we're going to be using the grid for our texture sheet. But for right now, let's grab some more objects. We're going to need this flooring here. It's kind of like a concrete, poured concrete floor, and we'll extract that out of this texture, or out of this photograph. And later on we'll be making textures out of these, so this isn't going to be the final texture. I'm going to go by this edge here, because that's the closest one to our edge, and then I'm going to go right near it, and kind of just make it look like it would be that way. Bring it up and extend these edges out. Extend that one. If you hold shift too, you'll get a aligned mode. So this looks a little bit better. At least that's the orange color is lined up, but the dark color is not, which not a huge deal because we could just crop that and then just copy this. Control C, Control V, or Control J, I mean, and then rotate it by the horizontal and then drag it over to the other side. And we're going to line this up, and then we'll have the entire floor texture. So I'm just going to use a clone brush here to paint this in, and a little bit at the top here too. And then I'll just merge all these layers, and then hit Control A to copy all. Or just drag it over, and just hit yes. Now we have our floor. You get some more parts from our reference documents. I'm going to start on this one here. You can kind of see where it is over on the side here. So we're gonna open up that and just take a look at our reference here, see if we got any better shots. This one seems to look the best. So we'll go with that one, just open it in Photoshop and then duplicate it and make sure we save our original. I'm just gonna duplicate the layer and then we're gonna crop, or we're gonna duplicate it one more time, and then because we'll be using it later. And I just want to crop this door out here. If we think about this for a second, what part do we need? Do we need just the door, or do we need the door and the window above it? I think I'm gonna do that here. I think we'll get the door and the window above it. It did seem to work out the best before, so make sure on perspective here, and then crop this out once more, and then drag this over to get that end piece there, and then the top. I think that's where our problem lied before. So if we just bring that down a little bit and line it up with this, that'll be lined up there, about right there probably. And this looks much better now. I think it's lining up pretty well now. So. And you can just grab a guide and check it if you want yourself. This is pretty good. I think we need to just grab that and throw it in our texture sheet, holding shift, and then drag it over. And so that's good for now. Let's just put that over here for right now. We'll probably move it later. And grab a guide down and see if it's all level. Looks pretty good. So now what I want to do is our scaling is a little bit off. So we need to find a reference for the total scale of all our pictures. So what I want to do is make sure that I use this image here for our main scale. And then when we get these other parts, they're going to have to be scaled accordingly so that they match the other parts, because not all the pictures are taken from the same distance. So, I'm trying to look for the best image that would give us everything in our scene that would make our scale work well. So, I kind of want to get a little bit of everything, maybe this one or this one. Probably this one, because it's got a lot of the different things in it. But we could use this one also. Okay, we're going to use this one. So, basically, I just want to grab this whole thing and throw it into our texture space, and then put that away back. And then I want to scale our picture here up to the door that we just did. So I'm going to put those on the bottom layer or above the layer and try to match this up here by scaling our images so that they fit the scale of the whole project. So I'm just going to scale this up here and make sure that our door fits right in that spot where it would be in the picture. So it's pretty close, it needs to be a little bit more. The bottom's lining up, but the top's still a little bit, needs a little bit more. And let's get a little closer view. That looks pretty good. Now that it's scaled, or we have a reference of scale, we can go back and scale our door accordingly to this scale. So I'm gonna start over here on the left, the right side of it, and then scale it up. And it should be about right there. That looks about right. And now our scale is correct. So that's just a little trick that I learned over time, is to just bring a reference in and then scale one thing to that and then use everything else to that scale. I want to make sure this piece here, this middle window, is to the right scale. It looks like it, you know, it looked good originally, but compared to our door here, it's a little bit off. So we're going to drag it over here and scale it down to where it would be about. And I think that the same height, it's hard to tell because the image is like set back. I'm gonna just move on. And then I'm gonna just gonna take this selection and make the rest of our materials out of this one. So if we bring this in here, and then just place this up out of the way, we can grab the rest of our window here. Now we have to rescale the image according to our door. That's the correct scale. So all we gotta do is just scale it up, make sure it fits, make sure it lines up. It's not quite right just yet. We gotta scale it down a little bit. We scaled it too much. And now we can see that it's scaled fairly well. You know, that's, it's dead on right there. So it's just a little bit, the picture's a little bit turned or rotated. So we're gonna have to fix that. So what I want to do is actually just rotate the entire our image, because we know the door is scaled correctly and it fit it, the line was straight across when we tested it. So it's our second or our background image that we needed to rotate. What I want to do is grab the other textures from this. So I'm gonna make a couple copies of it and grab this kind of tarnished copper material and make sure that it's the full height. And drag select this marquee over here. And then copy it, hit Control C and then Control J. And now I'm gonna grab this this window here. So I'm just gonna grab it from the top left to the bottom right, and make sure we get this granite back down here too. And then I also want this top piece here, so I'm just gonna grab a small portion of it and we'll just tile it. So that's copied. And then we need this Fox box office sign at the top here. So maybe just rotate a little bit more so that the line lines up with our grids. Yeah, so it's you know, it's still a little bit off, so we could just rotate it. That looks okay, but let's just move it to the left just a hair, and then hit enter. And then we're just going to copy this top piece here and grab half of the width, and then we'll just, when we build our final one, we'll mirror it over. So that's copied. Now let's take a look at all our pieces and place them together. In it's kind of like a jigsaw puzzle. Just kind of put the pieces together, and but it's for a texture sheet, so it's I usually try to get the most out of my texture space by moving things in just the right places and then snapping them to each other. Sometimes we'll have to put like doors, we'll have to rotate it and move it 90 degrees so that we could fit other space filled in different order so that we get the most use out of our texture space. And then I want to this piece, just gonna move it over there for right now. We have the window here. That's the same size as that piece, so we're gonna put that next to that. This, I think I'm just gonna rotate it and put it down here too. Make sure there's no white space in between. And then we're gonna have to move this little piece somewhere because it's below a piece we already have. And that looks pretty good for right now, so I'm just gonna do a save and just name it map set 1. And so now it's just gonna do a save. And now we have our, what I want to do now is our windows. So let's try to find the best window reference we have for the upper windows. I think that's going to be maybe one of these here, or this one here. Yeah, this one's a pretty good one. This one's, it's a little bit different, but this one looks like the best reference we can use to find. To make this piece. So now we have this piece. I'm just going to duplicate the layer and then we make sure we crop this. But first I want to make sure we make it so that we have all the pieces we need from this one singular piece. So we have two windows that we're going to need in two black spaces, decoration spaces, and then we have the walls. So if I move this over to the frame of the window and then move this over to the other edge, and this one the same spot but at the top, I think that will cut out everything that we actually need in order to make our 3D model fit. And I'm just going to drag this over a little bit to the right. That looks good, so let's hit the check mark or enter. And that came out pretty good, but we don't need this top here above the window. That's not going to be useful for us. And we don't need below the bottom window. So we just need in between. So I'm just going to crop this and then drag it into our texture sheet. Hit yes. And now we're kind of running out of room. So I think that we're going to have to make two texture sheets, an A and a B. So I'm going to label this set 2 and set 1. And we'll start dividing them into different sets right now. And also, we'll make it so that we use the best amount of texture space in both sets. So I'm going to put this on set 2. And what I'm concerned about now is our scale. So we want to make this to scale. I'm going to try to grab these pieces here and see if we can use those as well before we scale everything. So we're going to take this piece and figure out what is the best piece to fit here. So we're going to crop this. First, we're going to drag our perspective lines to something that's gonna make it the exact perspective. So like this, this gap here, let's drag it to that, and then at the top, and that looks a bit off, so I want to do a little bit to the left, and then move it up and grab that, slide this a little bit up more, and then slide that down, slide this over, and then make sure we get everything to the right of this too. And I kind of want to make the two ends tileable, so I'm going to cut off the block in the middle, near the bottom there. And I think this is good. So Yeah, we want the top there. So, looks like. See if this is gonna tie out correctly. So I'm just gonna duplicate this layer, and then go to other, and then offset. Oops, went to minimum. Go to offset, and looks like it's gonna tie all fairly well. So I'm just gonna drag this into our texture sheet, and. Oh, it's off. So this is set 2. So I'm gonna put it in set 1 for right now, because I think it's gonna fit better, maybe in this area here. Let's bring this back up here and kind of see what we're gonna do next, which is this piece here, this little detailed piece underneath to the side of the big windows, and we're gonna grab our corners and line them up. So I just want to get this right, so I'm gonna line it up to the very bottom edge, and then I'm gonna line them up with these window frames. And then we'll just expand it to what we need. So we only need about this much here. And maybe. Maybe just a little bit on the ends and hit OK. And I'm just gonna cancel this and turn off my snap. And then crop this. Looks like we got a little bit black on the left side, so I'm just going to crop it once more. And that should be good. But I want to clone stamp out this decoration at the top here. Now, I think we could drag it over to our texture sheet. So I think that's it for this lesson. So I'll see you in the next one, which will be the creating and testing the 2D paper model.